Hi, I'm Sam Harwell. I'm a member of the .NET Developer Experience team here at Microsoft. And in addition to working on the C# and Visual Basic IDE experiences, our team is heavily focused on inner-loop developer productivity. As part of this, we're frequently asked to help teams and other divisions around Microsoft when their developer tools seem slow. Over time, we've seen some common patterns emerge with simple solutions that greatly improve their experiences. By sharing this knowledge, we're hoping you'll be able to see similar benefits. Our goal today is to show some of our expectations for IDE performance so that you can better identify problematic scenarios and resolve them to maximize your team productivity.
Hi, my name is Drew Noakes, and I'm an engineer on the .NET and Visual Studio teams here at Microsoft. Lately, I've been focusing on improving the performance of builds across Visual Studio. We have a bunch of performance improvements coming in Visual Studio 2022, which will help make you more productive. While we do everything we can to make builds faster by default, there may still be things you can do to improve the performance of your builds. Today, we're talking specifically about incremental builds, so let's explore what that is. And we'll do that in this solution. We have a very simple solution here. It just has two projects. You can see there's a console application and a class library, and the console application has a reference to the class library. So let's do the first build. This is not an incremental build. This is a full build. Nothing has been built before. We see that everything completed, and it took about a second. We can see that there were two projects that were built. There were no errors, and nothing was up to date. Now, if we build again, we would expect what we've built previously to kick in and everything to be up to date. So let's check that. And indeed, we see that two projects were up to date. That is the essence of incremental build. Nothing has changed, so there was nothing to change, nothing to build. It's the increment is, you can think of it as the part that you change, and it will build just that part and avoid doing that redundant work. And you can see in this case, there was nothing to do beyond working out that we were up to date, and that was quite quick. It took about 30 milliseconds. And you see we run it again a few times. It continues to be very fast. So that's incremental build when it's working well, makes you much more productive. And it's worth noting that, you know, these build times don't happen just when you right-click build your project, but it'll also happen whenever you launch into the debugger or whenever you're running a unit test. Builds are a common task that you perform, and sitting around waiting for a build to complete is never a great use of time.
So here we have another solution. It also has two projects, and it's structured very similar to the first solution that we just looked at. And you'll notice that in this solution, if you try to follow the original steps of you build the first time, you see that it built two projects. Again, two succeeded, no fail, and none were up to date. And the build time was about the same as what we saw before, taking 1 second. However, for this solution, if I was to do the same thing again without making any changes, instead of seeing the 20 millisecond quick up to date, I notice that it still takes almost 3/4 of a second. And one project is saying succeeded and one is saying up to date. This isn't an error condition. Everything is building successfully, but it's not behaving with the performance level that we expected for an incremental build where nothing changed. To figure out why this one solution built this time, and if I was to right-click and build solution, you'll see it happens again. We need to go and figure out why Visual Studio did not think the solution was up to date when I ran that second and third build. To do this, in Tools Options, under Projects and Solutions and SDK Style Projects, there's a logging level related to the up-to-date check. If I change that from the default value of none over to minimal, each build is going to have an extra line explaining the reason why the build started instead of being considered up-to-date. And for this solution, this line, the fast up-to-date check, says a file, this in particular, data.json, has copy to output directory set to copy always. And therefore, the solution in this particular project is considered never up to date. This is a fairly common situation that teams have accidentally gotten themselves into. And the solution is quite simple. If you find the offending file, in our case data.json, and open the properties window, I can see that copy to output directory is set to copy always. By changing this to copy if newer, the build will still run each time I change this file. However, if I build the solution the first time, it says the solution had a change, and the change was I set the value to copy if newer. However, subsequent builds where I don't make any changes to the properties or to the content of any of the files are now considered immediately up to date, and we're back to the 20 millisecond builds that the first example had. By changing the value to copy if newer instead of copy always, I didn't lose the ability to make a change to this JSON file and then build the solution and see that it did rebuild the project in question. However, each time you build without making any changes to that file, you're back to the 20 millisecond build times.
Thanks, Sam. Let's look at another example now, which is a little harder to diagnose, but will help us to show another scenario that incremental build problems can surface in. Here we have a very similar project. Although we don't have a data.json file anymore, what we now have is this package reference, and we're referencing this should-ly library. And you'll see that when we build, the first time, two succeeded, as we would expect. We built another time, now we're seeing that incremental build did not happen, and actual build occurred. So let's have a look at the error message and see if it helps us. And this time, it's not talking about any file in our project. It's talking about some debug symbols, this PDB file. So that's a little bit less clear what's going on. It's saying that some file does not exist. Well, actually, the debugging of this was a bit more involved and it required some additional tools. Something called the MSBuild Structured Log Viewer was very valuable here. We'll skip the exact details of the issue and just talk about sort of the symptoms and how to fix it in this particular instance. So here you see we're using this should-ly library. So MSBuild is a very customizable platform, and it's possible for package references, NuGet packages, to include files that modify your build. So in this particular instance, should-ly version 4.0.1 performed some build customization that broke incremental builds for that project. Now, in version 4.0.3, that issue has been resolved. So if we save that, upgrade to the newer version of the package, we've made a change, so building will actually cause a build. And if we build again, now we see we're back up to date. So this really highlights that sometimes these issues are things that you may have direct control over in your project file, but they may also come from other sources.
Thanks, Drew. I know these scenarios are very complicated, and there's a whole bunch of different reasons why things could end up impacting build performance. We've included some resources in the description below. Some of these are tools that we use here at Microsoft to diagnose the problems that other teams are facing. And we also have included some links to our Report a Problem tool, which will allow you to reach out to us if you're not able to resolve these and you're seeing performance that doesn't match what you want to see at your company. Finally, if you're a team member that works on build performance that affects a large number of other developers, I would encourage you to reach out and make sure that other people on the team are seeing the same improvements that you're seeing for improvements that are made. We've seen some cases where an individual user's settings led to their builds being slower than the rest of the team. And any time that you let a situation like that go on for a while, that team member could end up being less productive. Even though a simple change of settings to be consistent would improve it for them. Also, remember that builds are a very resource-intensive process. So if the steps previously aren't working for you, you may find that improving the hardware that you're working with could have a pretty big impact. In particular, builds benefit from SSD storage, both for the operating system and for the drive containing the project you're working on.